Good morning. So we're here on Spyro 3, but basically we're continuing from last night, but we've gone back to the very first world. We're in Sunrise Spring World, and the reason for that is because on the trophy list we realised we were missing a trophy and we couldn't work out what it was. So we've gone for a little mooch and we've come to this signpost, and if you go to this signpost it puts you in a new level, which is a bonus level, and we believe this is where the trophy comes from. So we're going to try and get that now. This is going to be more or less a quick stream. Me and Claire are going to be making our breakfast in between, taking turns and having a mooch around. And basically this is our Sunday day today. We're chilling out doing Spyro 3. We're going to see how far we get in a good few streams, but we'll probably just end up running in and out of levels, and then, like I say, doing a bit of a clean up towards the end in maybe one or two episodes, going 100% in things and collecting the platinum trophies. So with that said, sit back, relax and enjoy. Here we go. We're going to go into this signpost level, guys, and try and get this Crawdad Farm trophy. So see you on the other side.
Hello, Sparks! Before you take on those nasty crawdads, I should give you some help. To start, let's practice shooting. Press the attack button to shoot these targets. You can also move quickly by pressing the charge. Dragonfly, you can also strafe in any direction. Butterflies that give you health, just like in the dragon world. Not only that, but some butterflies will give you special powers, though only for a short time. You'll be able to deal with these. Much faster if you use a power-up. Just eat any power-up butterfly, then press the jump button.
Sparks, if you need.
Nice work, Sparks.
You need five people.
Those crummy Rhinox forced us to build a statue of the source. I am almost ready to reveal my latest piece of real-time four-dimensional performance art. I call it Hideous Exploding Witch. Oops, I forgot.
Isn't this the wildest skateboard park you've ever seen? Once you've mastered a few tricks, you could really rack up a huge score in this place. What do you say I show you some moves? Let's start with something easy. You can jump off the end of ramps by pressing the jump button. I'll show you how to do it once, then it's your turn. Okay, now try doing a roll. You can roll in midair by holding down the action button while steering left or right with the left stick. Nice roll! Now let's see you pull a flip. Flips are exactly like rolls, only you push forward or back on the left stick instead of left or right. Just jump off the right. Must be a natural. Now let's see if you can pull off a half pipe spin move. The blue ramps are half pipes. You can do a spin move by jumping at the top of the blue ramp, then steering left or right in the air. Alright, you nailed it! Now let's see if you can do a 900. Get as much height as you can, spin 2.5 revolutions in the air, and land back on the ramp. Was a 900. I have to admit, you've got some skills, Spyro. But before you get too cocky, let's see if you can score some real points on the giant ski. Wow, you learn really fast! Well, then again, you are being trained by a master boarder. Speaking of which, I was just practicing this nearly impossible new move that I call the Nasty Nork. I had just about pulled it off when suddenly I ran smack into this dragon egg. was playing catch with my pet wolf, Farley, but I accidentally threw his ball down this hole.
Found Farley.
Are you on vacation too? I was having...
Spyro, Rhinox have been... We would be honored if you would accept this as a...